John Ernest Johnny Crawford was born on the 26th of March, 1946 in Los Angeles, California, in the United States, of part German, British, and Russian descent. He is an actor, perhaps still best known for appearing in the role of Mark McCain in The Son of Lucas, played by Chuck Connors in the TV Western series entitled The Rifleman from 1958. He is also recognized as a musician. Have you ever wondered how rich Johnny Crawford is as of early 2016? According to Celebrity.Money, it's estimated that Johnny's net worth is over $1 million. His career in the entertainment industry has earned him a big part of his modest fortune over time. Johnny Crawford was born to Betty and Robert Lawrence Crawford, Sr. His older brother, Robert Jr., is also an actor. Johnny, together with his father and brother, was nominated for Emmy Awards in 1959. Thus, he was raised in a family full of actors and musicians, and under that influence, his professional acting career began while he was a child. Meantime, he attended Hollywood High School, from where he matriculated in 1964. Johnny's career began when he was still a child, appearing firstly in the Pinky Lee Show in 1950. 6 years later, he became more focused on acting, being cast in such TV series as The Lone Ranger, Telephone Time, and Make Room for Daddy in the mid-50s. Then, in 1958, he was chosen for the role of Mark McCain in the highly popular TV series Rifleman through 1963, which increased his net worth by a large degree. After the series ended, Johnny looked for another long-term commitment and managed to land roles in such productions as Indian Paint, Village of the Giants, and The Restless Ones, both in 1965, and then appeared in El Dorado in 1966 with John Wayne and Robert Mitchum in lead roles. Before the end of the decade, he also starred in Hawaii Five-O and The Big Valley, among others, all of which increased his net worth. In the 1970s, Johnny's career declined somewhat, and he appeared only in minor roles in films and TV series such as The Naked Ape, The Inbreaker, and The Great Texas Dynamite Chase, but certainly increased his net worth. His career took a turn for the better in the 1980s as he appeared in such popular productions as Macbeth, The All-American Cowboy, and William Tell in 1987 and 88, among others, all of which added to his net worth. Before he decided to retire from acting, Johnny made several appearances in the 1990s in films and TV series such as The Gambler Returns, The Luck of the Draw, in which he repeated his role from The Rifleman, Rupert Patterson Wants to Be a Superhero in 1997, and The 13th Floor in 99, all adding steadily to his net worth. Johnny has also been recognized as a musician, and since 1992, he has been the leader of a California-based vintage dance orchestra with which he has released one album, Sweepin' the Clouds Away, in 2012, which also increased his net worth. Regarding his personal life, Johnny Crawford has been married to Charlotte Samco since 1994, and although they are apparently now separated, he is also known as a former member of the AJRA, American Junior Rodeo Association, and the PRCA, Professional Rodeo Cowboys Association.